Thank you. So that's the one that's the handwritten one is that one. The other one is yeah, that's the other one.
That's the other one.
Well, not other one, but that's the original one, right? Because if we didn't it's only handwritten in. Someone added it in. But so the question then is, why was it added in?
Yeah, because why?
No. It's not just her. No, it's a photocopied in. We all have it.
Oh, we all have.
So it's just basically just the
same.
So
you want us?
Yeah.
Want us to see?
I think.
Okay. Well, no, don't add another two or three.
Try just try. Just try.
Okay.
One word.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. How about we do the second soprano and the alto line, just the last line, just coming into the end.
So don't
repeat the word. Don't repeat the word, and then just one word here. And then
three, four.
That's the other thing. Yeah, that like.
Because we are not the main melody. They are.
How come I remember I sing your part, the last three notes?
You know, it's probably possible.
So I think maybe you swap to still sing Xiwang and then auto.
Okay, try the other way.
Auto bark.
You put back the words.
Put back the word. Okay.
Thank you.
Ahoy, ahoy, not too ding dong bum bum. And then, oh, I measure 7 for soprano. Just those 4 notes of that scale. Somehow the second and the third note was flatter than it should be. End of the pitch, right? I haven't really changed notes, but you can tell what I'm, you know. Okay, good. Can we go? Let's do the end again. Good. So know, just a soprano one, as long as it's, you know, more of your main melody in the second page, that'd be good. So then, and then for second soprano, and also just be adjust to just you know a little bit less, so that it's so that you can always hear the. You know, I know it's only like two little things, but be able to hear that, or else it could be too loud. Okay, good. All right, let's go to back to the quiet one. The quiet one is actually okay. We just have to move along a little faster. I think we're very cautious. That's all, because we're like, oh, we don't want to make a mistake, you know, sort of a thing. And because we don't want to make a mistake, it's fine, but it's just slow. Overall, it's really slow, so then it makes it kind of hard to sing because you feel like you're always running out of breath. All right. The beginning is good. I just have to play a few notes here and there just to sort of check it. The second soprano, the first G sharp you sing. It's actually maybe just a little bit too, I don't know, it's a semitone, but if we're maybe just, we can give it a little bit more space. So, forward. sing Yarud. Oh, even more forward. Right. Here we go. Between the soprano one part and the alto part, you exchange notes. So, for example, in 15, look at 15, measure 15. In measure 15, soprano one sings an F sharp, right? Mm-hmm. And then alto, you need to sing your way to the F sharp that matches their F sharp. So there's a way of checking to make sure that we actually do it right. Okay, so it should match when we get there. So if we went there and we stopped and paused, it should be just two notes. It should be just the D and then the F sharp. Okay, now the other one to look for is measure 18. Same idea, similar, at least similar idea. The soprano one have the F natural, and then altos, when you come up to your F natural, it should be the same F natural that they just left. So you just take over the F natural from them. Okay, so let's not test those two, but basically just check those two spots, because those two are what will tell if we get it right. So can we just have 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, just 15, and just soprano one and alto. So, and we're going to sing both of them, and we just want to make sure we end up on the same F sharp. Just because they have a different word and you, right? So that's okay, but as long as we have the same note, that's important. Okay, let's try again. One, two. Good. Can we put O's, O's in the middle, okay? One, two. Sing the bar. Like that. Okay. One, two. moso is agitated and with more motion. So we didn't really sing it very agitated. Or at least we didn't sound like you were very agitated. So okay, can we sing Ha Song Fong Eddie? Yeah, you're gonna describe to us what you everything that went wrong. You gotta tell everyone that then this happened, this happened, then this happened. But no, I lost this and I lost this and I lost this. You know, it's like that. Like more. Okay? So a bit more wordy, a little bit less legato. 33 and 34, there's no like full fermata or anything. It's just slower and then right into the 2-4. So the sentence is actually not the sentence, the paragraph is not over between 33 and 34. So 33 builds into 34, so don't take too much time between 33 and 34. Basically, be ready to go. So, one beat, full, you know, and not really. Just be ready to just slow down a little bit. Ooh, one, two, one, two, one, two, one. Okay, good. All right, let's go from the agitato again. Getting better. And one, two, three.
Thank you.
just a few things I would say. If you can take some time to, because now that we've sang for some time now, and the words are okay, to help just being able to sing it in a way that makes sense, like from a voce program, I highly suggest you to write the English above the sentence. So you have the translation here, so just write it above the sentence so it makes some sense. And so, for example, I'll give you an example. So the beginning, okay? The beginning is you're talking about when you were younger, you had dreams. You thought you were a superhero. And you thought because you're a superhero and you have a good heart that you were going to make the world a better place, right? So we begin, petite fille, je les aimais. It's really bad. As a child, I had a dream. You know, sing it like that, so it makes a bit more sense. If you put the English in there, it'll help you, remind you what the sentence is supposed to say. So, as a little child, you know, so, as a child, I had a dream of dancing, living in a fantasy, you know, or something like this. Like, the idea is that you're so innocent, everything is possible. Everything is possible. You don't have the world that you know. You don't have to live life to then realize that oh, I can't do everything. Right? That's later on. So so in the whole from measure 1 to measure 14, you're talking about your childhood and how you thought you can do everything and you're going to go out there and you can change the world. You know, make the world a better place. So. It's like I wanted to be a warrior, proud and fierce, so that I can fight. 13. So fight against hardship, because you don't want, you know, people should be not have to be so, you know. And then you notice it's a crescendo to letter B, right? He lutte contre la misère. You're gonna like, I want to fight against hardship, and letter B, but. That's right. So B is like but, right? And reality hit. So that's why B has to be more subito piano. It has to be more sudden that we get quieter, and then. So it's saying that, but I didn't become a warrior. I didn't become any of this, right? So. I'm just a very ordinary girl. So it's a simple fille, simple girl.
Simple girl.
Right? I'm just a simple girl. Okay? And then to song and all my great dreams, right? And all those beautiful dreams. Si noble et beau is like noble and beautiful. And then la vie, les a to s'effacer is life has erased. So you're like, oh, you know, growing up now, it's like, oh, real life tells me it's not possible. So that's why you get to the end of it, from B to the end of the page is actually more kind of like, but I'm just a normal person and nothing. All those great dreams, you know, they're not possible. Okay, so that's the mood change between the beginning of this verse and the last part of the verse. Okay, then we sing it now and then sing it like that. So very hopeful, I'm invincible, I can do anything. And then when we get to letter B, but real life hit you. I grew up, and then this is what really happened. Okay, so.
Thank you.
The letter C, you're going to, so when dreams are not possible anymore, when dreams disappear, then what else is there? So that's curiosity. Curiosity is the question. What remains, so what left? Right? So when dreams disappear, what remains? And then when our dreams don't speak anymore, right? Because they don't, you know, they don't influence you anymore. You're like, oh, those dreams, they're kind of gone, right? So when the dreams don't speak anymore, what remains? And then the very last one, what remains? So you're asking a question, right? And then of course you're gonna answer that question in verse 2, right? Okay, so that's the explanation for the chorus, okay? So it's sort of bittersweet. It's not that it's like completely like depressing, right, this page. You're asking a question. So where did they go? You know? So you know, I had all these dreams, where did they go? Okay, so let's sing letter C again. Become a warrior. So, déjeuner pas été guerrier. So, guerrier is warrior, and je n'ai pas is I didn't. Right? So, I did not become a warrior. And then, letter F. Je n'ai pas su changer le monde. Monde is earth, and changer is change. Right? So, I didn't change the
world.
I didn't change the world, because that was what you wanted to do. You wanted to change the world, right? So, je n'ai pas su changer le monde. Le même page. Tu comprends je le verrais. So as I had thought I dreamed. So you know, I didn't change the world. I didn't change the world like I thought I would in my dream. That's basically the sentence. All right. So that's that. And then this time, letter G is more hopeful. The first time, the letter G section was like, oh, but I'm just. It didn't happen. Just a simple girl. This time is more hopeful. That's why we have to sing. Although the sounds are similar, you have to sing it differently, right? So G. So for the people I love, I am refuge. I'm sure there's probably a few extra English words put into there, but basically the idea is that I'm not complete. It's not to say I'm completely useless or that I didn't do anything with my life. It's just that but. Through my life, I was able to become these things. And then you're going to say them. Okay, so to some people, I was able to be a refuge, like a place where people can take shelter, right? So, you know, you're having a hard time, you can come to me and I can be your comfort, right? So refuge. For those in pain, I am their courage, right? So this is, pour ceux, je suis courageux, okay, courage. Pour ceux qui n'ont plus, for those who do not hope for tomorrow, demain is tomorrow, okay? Je suis promesseur, je suis is I am. So je suis promesseur, which is promise. So if for people who don't think tomorrow will come, if you think tomorrow will come, then you think it's promising, promising that tomorrow will come. So for people who don't think tomorrow will come, you are their promise that tomorrow will come. Does that make sense? And then the last one, I'm not really sure how to explain, but I am, je suis, I am, village, their village, or I am the village, or I am, community. Okay? And then, so that explains how this part works. So letter G is more hopeful. Letter B was more, it's not defeat, but it's sort of like, well, but this is just the way things are. Okay? Yeah. Okay? Letter C has a little bit of melancholy. Letter E still has a little bit of melancholy. And then letter G is hopeful. Yeah. So change the mood. Okay? So let's go sing page 5.
Thank you.
See, I think the beginning, when we start the canon, we need a little bit more of this kind of like, because you start the new pattern, and so we don't actually hear the new pattern until it sort of starts, everybody else does it. So we just need a little bit more of soprano one each time the new one comes in. Yeah, so that makes sense. Good, just in the middle, just remember, because it's all unison, we want to match the vowel as very listen very carefully for that. And so you remember a couple of weeks ago, we did that, you know, long exercise just for the middle here. So when we get to so we just want to listen very carefully to each other and adjust so that it sounds more like one person than maybe like three persons. No. Okay, so I'm more closer to a very, very good unison line. Okay, for that. Good. But otherwise, that's basically it. Just a little bit more with the canon. We just need a little bit more of soprano one just to get us going. So we hear the change. Like, we hear the change in the piano because the piano harmony changes when you change. But then we just need more of the actual, the new motive that get passed down. That's all. Okay, good. Song 47. Hey, well, we're making good progress.
Thank you. Thank you.
weight of his hand, single, is okay, but the next page is hands. So you put it as running my hands through his, running my hands through his hand. It's S, S, double is okay. And then thank you. Thank you.